Sorry, I was trying to find the right great audio level for that. All right, let's get started. You know what? I actually need to turn things on. I didn't have monitor capture on. I know I was forgetting something. I knew I was forgetting to do something. I knew it. I knew I was forgetting something. And I forgot to do this. Oh my god. Wow, I really just went live and didn't think about anything beforehand. Look at that. See, I have to turn the camera to this thing because otherwise I get like half the frame rate and it looks really shitty. So I have to turn off the stuff there. We're gonna do a game dev goal. What are we gonna do as our game dev goal? We're gonna rework and ghost animations is what we're gonna be doing. That's what we're gonna be doing today. Or at least for right now. It shouldn't honestly take that long, but we'll see what happens. Anyway, hello everybody. How y'all doing today? We got Kiwa in here. We got Donnie in here. Super Junior Pac-Man, Glitchberry. And I thought I saw somebody else. Am I wrong? I think I'm wrong. Yeah, I'm wrong. I didn't see anybody else. Hi, Donnie. Yes, Donnie, whenever you finish your stuff, I want to see it. I would really love to see it. Kami Tama, hi. Haven't seen you in a bit. Hope you're doing well. So happy Tuesday, everybody. I have tomorrow off, which I'm really, really happy about. I've had 5 days in a row that I was working. Let's do this as well, because I did not get... There we go. So yeah, I had 5 days in a row, which isn't like huge or anything. It's not like that's like horrible, but I don't know. Something about this last week was awful. Like people just got on my nerves, man. People just got them. I'm shaking my fist at them because they got on my nerves real bad. Like today, for example, this guy, I was talking to Molly. Sometimes Tuesdays, Pizza Hut have sale. What? I tell you, sometimes Tuesday. This guy, oh my gosh. So like, he was my first customer for the day. My first customer for the day. I sold him a charger for his battery. He left and was like, okay, well, you know, maybe I'll contact you guys if I need anything else. Cool, that's fine. Dude contacts me at 5:54. We close at 6. Contacts me at 5:54 and asks if I have a battery to replace the one that he bought the charger for when he first came in at 9:00 in the morning. And I told him, yeah, I have that. And he's like, okay, well, can you stay open for me? I can be on my way. I'll be there in like 15 minutes. And I'm like, dude, it's 5 till close. Well, yeah, I just didn't know what your policy was on staying open for customers who are on their way. Super Junior Pac-Man, exactly my point. I was like, dude, you had all day. You were literally my first customer of the day. You were my first customer of the day. And you waited until 5 minutes before close to be like, I should go over there and get that battery. I was infuriated. I was like, no. I was like, no, man, I gotta get going. And I did. I had to run to another store to go get something. But oh my gosh, like it was just a day full of that kind of stuff. And it was just so frustrating. And I'm just like, I'm happy I have tomorrow off. I'm just gonna chill. I'm gonna relax. I may stream. I don't really know. Yeah, I don't get it. Like, and it's one of those weird things because I think as somebody who works in retail, like I've worked probably a good majority of my life in retail. As somebody who works in retail, if it's like 10 minutes before closing time, actually most times, if it's like a half hour before somewhere closes, I'm like, I'll go tomorrow. Like that's just my immediate thought. Unless it's something that's like, unless they're like, it's a 30 minutes, they're 10 minutes away and I know what I need and I'm gonna go in there and get it within like 5 minutes. If it's like 30 minutes before close, I'm putting it off till the next day because I'm not gonna put the employees through that. You know, they need to close, the store closed then. Same thing with restaurants. If it's like an hour before they close, I don't go into a restaurant. Unless it's like drive-through, like Taco Bell or something like that. Because it's just, I feel like it's just rude. They have to close eventually. You know? I don't know. It's a weird thing. Just call you Raspberry? Well, for a while you were changing your name all the time to different berries. So I didn't know what to call you. But I don't know. I like calling you Glitchberry. Or Glitch. I think it's cute. But anyway. Okay, I'll call you Raspberry. That's fine. Anyway, for your pack fact, since we're on an original Pac-Man kick right now, the original Pac-Man actually made $1 billion in quarters in its first year in 1980. Like, what the fuck, man? That's a lot of money. I mean, obviously, it's not all going to one place. It went to all the different places, but still, $1 billion? $1 billion with a B? Anyway, Extron also, I learned some code I wrote for work back in November. Never got built. You're reminding me of my first job. I worked in a grocery store. We weren't allowed to tell people we were closing soon. One night, a little old lady came in near closing time and shopped until a half hour after we closed. Yeah, people do that. Like, they literally will. They don't give a shit. And the Kroger around here, like, literally announces a half hour before they close. They go on the intercom. They're like, hey, we're closing in 30 minutes. Better hurry up and get your shit done. Like, I'm not even joking. They are out. They are telling you that. Yeah, a lot of people don't. So what I'm going to work on here is, tonight, my goals are to, I had an idea today to rework the animations for the ghost object. Because right now we've got our normal animation, which is, you know, this. We've got our four frame animation. We have blue. We've got our flashing animation. We've got eyes. And then we have an angry animation. Okay. Now, back when I was making Pac-Man 37 the first time, what I had in here was it was something very similar to this right here. So, like, what I did was I have, instead of just being a four direction, I have, what is this? This is 16. Yeah, 16 directions. And I would have something like this. Like, I would have the down animation, and then I'd have this one. And I would use that as, like, the early turnaround animation, like, where they turn before they go in an intersection. And I had one on both sides. So I would be using, like, 12 of the 16 animation directions. But with this new engine, I don't need that. So, what I thought about doing, because with there being, like, his walking animation is basically a default animation. And angry is basically a default animation. It's just when he goes into Cruise Elroy mode. But it still is his default animation. It's not his blue, it's not his eyeballs, it's his default, essentially. So what I thought about doing instead was putting, since I'm not using extra directions here, putting the angry animation up here in the walking animation, and then just changing the direction if he's angry, because then I don't have to dedicate another animation for him being angry. I can just change his direction, and all of my events for when he's normal will still apply. And I don't have to have two sets of events, one for normal and one for angry animation. I can just do normal. So I thought about that and I was like, I can make this work, and that's easy. Of course, it's nothing now, but back then, a billion quarters is a guaranteed. Yeah, like a billion quarters is insane. That's, well, $1 billion in quarters. I don't think it's a billion quarters, but still. That's nutso. All right, so let's do that. Let's grab, because the other part of why this is good, hang on, I completely lost track of my train of thought. And I'll show you why in a moment. So I'm not going to just say it right now, but I will show you in a moment. But there's another reason why this is a good thing. Yeah, it's just it's really cool to me that I have like basically completely like reduced and simplified this Ghost engine in general. Like the amount of coding space I have saved on everything by using qualifier groups and stuff like that is nuts. We are multiple personalities, which is why we keep changing the username, if you are wondering. Oh, I did not know that. Hello, Molly! How you doing, Molly? How you doing, Molly? Hope you're having a good day. I was just telling them about the guy that I was screaming about, that I mentioned on the Twitter post to you. The reason why he made me scream was because he came in. He was my first customer of the day, right? He came in, he was my first customer of the day. He bought a battery, or he bought a charger for his battery at home. And then, that was 9 o'clock in the morning. And then he calls me, we close at 6, and he calls me at 5:54 p.m. saying that he needs to buy the battery because the one that he had that I sold him the charger to was bad, and he needs to get a replacement. And he was wondering if I could stay open until he got there because it was only going to be like a 15-minute drive. And I'm like, bitch, you had all fucking day. And I told him no. I was like, no. He's like, you guys don't have like a policy for staying open for customers who are on their way? And I was like, no, man, I got to go. And it's going to take you like, he's like, it's only like 10 minutes. And I was like, yeah, but you're driving in like 5 to 6 p.m. traffic. It's going to be like 15, 20 minutes before you get here. Some businesses, if my manager were on the phone, he would tell me to stay open, but I'm not fucking doing it. Anyway, the other reason that this whole thing helps me is because if I go over here and go into our skin, our Blinky skins object, you can see here we also have in here, we've got blue, we've got flash, we've got the eyes animation, and we have an angry animation here too, which I did make some angry animations for the retro style. But if I do this, then I can get rid of these extra animations, and I won't have so many. Look how many animations I have in here. I don't know if you can even see it. It's down in this little bottom corner over here, but like behind the cup. Like, look how many animations are in there. There's so many. It's a huge scroll bar. That'll eliminate one animation per group of skins. So it's very good. It's very, very good. So I'm going to go ahead and do this here. Oh, I don't need to do that on that one. We're going to go back up to stopped, and we're going to increase this one. Oh my God, the Thomas. The Thomas! Don't talk to me, I'm angry. Yeah, it was one of those frustrating things where I was just like, come on, man. Like, don't do that shit. Don't call a store like a little over 5 minutes, less than 10 minutes before they close, and just expect them to stay open for you. Like, go fuck off. Is that Linux? Hey, babe. I didn't think you'd be home this soon. That's right. But I didn't know if they were going to keep you all day or not.
Can't afford to.
I know, but I looked at the schedule. I was like, he's not home until... He ain't home until 9.
Nope, not today.
Yeah. So, yeah, I'm going to have to go through, and this is the part that's going to be a little time-consuming and a little tedious, is we are going to... I have to basically go copy these animations from each one of these different things and merge them into that, and then reduce the animations, and it's just going to be a pain. So we're gonna go through that, but that's what we're gonna be doing. We'll just be chatting and hanging out while I do this monotonous task, and you guys get to keep me company. You have to go to the bank tomorrow. Why you gotta go to the bank? You gotta get that money.
You withdrawing money from me.
Linux wants money. Money, please.
It's not that I want money. I need money.
Money, please.
Money,
Seeing retro Blinky Angie is best. Look at this, Donnie. Look what else I did. I haven't done. Oh yeah, I did plus Blinky Angry too. I haven't done classic, so I'm gonna work on that. We could probably do that a little bit. And then I did auto angry. I did auto. I got some auto angry eyes. I got the NES angry. So I made the NES one with angry eyes. And let's see here. Atari I didn't do. Atari is hard. How do you make this sprite look angry when the eyes are literally only 3 pixels anyway? I don't know how you would do that one. But I've got the SNES one in here. What?
Put this on discount.
For what, the tires?
No, this is for, I need these two together. Period.
The 99 and the 40?
These are the first.
That's eight.
That 99 is just a wheel alignment service. What they're gonna do is they're gonna warranty the one that we're gonna do today. That saved me about $40, but it voids out the warranty, and I'm like, fine, I don't care. First, the control arms and the play bars are gone.
Yeah. So,
that's very important. I'm missing one control arm, period. Just gone.
That's ridiculous.
What? That's because the guy used to work at Big Box, and then we started talking.
Nice! Yeah, so... Sorry about that, guys. So yeah, like I made this is the SNES/Genesis Blinky sprites from Miss Pac-Man. I made an Angy version of this one too. So we got Angy version on that. And I got the Pac-Man 2 one, and I made Angy on that one too. I made Angy on all of them. Is the Angy estate or an option? So what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make it probably an option to have the angry eyes, because in the original arcade game, Blinky went into Cruz Elroy mode, but he didn't actively like change animation. Like this animation was not in the original arcade game. So I don't, like, when you're playing, like, original Pac-Man, it's not something you normally see, but I want to give people the option to have it on if they want it on. Otherwise, I will just kind of leave it off. I think I will make the modern animation always do that, but any other animation that doesn't default to that, like, most of these skin options do not do that. So, yeah. Yeah, that Super Junior Pac-Man, that's actually a really good option right there. Modern only or all skins option, yeah. Like, just an option to give people, you know, something to do all of these. So this is going to be the hard part right here, is that I'm going to have to rename, because you can't just move, can I just delete this? Hang on, I'm going to see what happens here if I just delete this. If I just delete this animation, what happens? It still stays there. It won't go away. It stays in the list. It's such a pain, man. So what I have to do is I'm basically going to have to rename these and move them all up manually. So I'm gonna have to do this all manually, which is the part that I said is gonna be a little monotonous. But I need to do this now before I go on to the other ghosts, because I don't want to have, like if I did this and made the other ghosts, I'd have to go back and do this 4 times. I'd rather just get it all done now. So what we're gonna do here is gonna rename this as plus normal. And then we're just gonna basically copy these and put these over here and delete these ones. It's just basically gonna be a big pain in the butt. And I'm sorry if I'm coughing a lot, guys. I have a weird tickle in my throat. How to be angry but also rich. How to be rich. If only. I was just thinking about that today. I was thinking about that. while I was driving to work. Thinking about the fact that there's no real way to be rich, like stupid, stinky, filthy rich, without having like moral issues. We've already talked about that before on stream, but like literally, man, there's no way. You can't do it. Like, because like, you just can't. You can't, in good faith, be rich. Stupid, like, stupid, filthy witch. Like, you can't be a billionaire and have a good conscience. Like, you just can't do it. Because that basically is, in my opinion, you're denying other people a better life. Like, you've got the money to change people's lives, and you decide not to because you want it. When you've... Nobody needs that much money. Like, ever. Nobody needs that much money. That's part of why I was spiling earlier. Fuckerburger's going on Twitter. Yeah, I saw that. I saw that too, Molly. That's so fucking stupid. We're gonna charge you for security on your account. For only $10 a month, though, you guys. It's only $10 a month. It's only $10 a month, really. It's fine. This we're going to rename to plus blue. I'm just going to name these plus. And then we're going to grab our blue thing here, and we're just going to paste it in here. And we got to get rid of all these other animations. Yes. I did put those in here, right? Yeah, we got that. Angie up. Angie left, Angie down, Angie. And yes, I will be referring to them as Angie for the rest of the stream. Thank you. Rename this animation to be plus flash. But yeah, this will save me so many animations in here. So many animations. Like, you guys don't even know. And I'm so excited about that. I am so excited to be saving, because like, Every skin essentially uses 5 animations. And now I'm going to be reducing it to 4 animations. So just with, let's see, we've got retro, classic, plus classic. And then I've got the Atari, NES, SNES, and Pac-Man 2 skins in there right now. That's 8 skins in the game. So that's 8 animations I'm saving that I don't need to do. So in the option, or in the event that my animation frames are limited, then what this means is that this will allow potentially 2 more animations just in this realm right here. I can have 2 more skins in this same thing. I forgot what I was doing. Plus flash, we already put that there, right? Okay, that's already done. Now we need to rename this one plus eyes. Look at my eyes. Oh, boobs. But, oh. Why is that there? Okay. It's a weird thing. I think I was just using it for a placeholder. And then we're gonna go over here and grab this one and put this here. Loop, make sure all of these are looping animations. They are all looping animations, great. And then we don't need the Angie. We don't need the Angie. Imagine watching the Mega Compare Pac-Man video just for these skins. You need that channel point redeem. The little plant boy, yeah, I don't know why they gave him a little leaf sticking out of their head in Pac-Man Plus. It's weird. We're gonna click OK. Because we finished. We finished the plus animations. There we go. So that's good. Got those done. Now we need to... I just named them C. I'm going to rename this one Classic Normal. I might rename them back to C. Once I do this, but I can't have an animation be the same name as another animation, and so because of that I have to actually change these animation names, which is stupid. I always thought they turned into edible fruits, probably to convey, hey, you can eat us now. You know what, I didn't think of that before. That's a good point. They might have done it for that purpose. That might have been exactly what they did. Malt, how's it going, Malt? I hope you're doing well. I have a little bit of a headache, and I need to get that taken care of. I should go get some aspirin or something. Yeah, I hope everybody is having a good Tuesday. Existential crises and frustrations from the internet aside. It's so weird because, like, we think about how frustrated we get with the internet sometimes. And about how annoying it is seeing all this stuff on this overload of information from the internet. But at the same time, it's like, I feel like I'm more well-informed than I ever have been in my life. So it's like, I don't know. It's a weird trade-off. These are the Angie animations. I forgot about that. Let's get rid of these. Let's get rid of these. Let's get rid of these. The bottom one should be still 15. Okay, we're good. we need to rename this one to be Classic Eyes. Classic Eyes! Oh, wait, no, this needs to be Flash. Whoops. I about got out of order. Ooh, shit. And I think I'm gonna move the Atari ones first, just because my OCD wants them to be in order. About to make garlic shrimp stir fry. Oh. Mania sprites probably won't be needed since your modern pretty much emulates. Yeah, I was thinking the same thing, Donnie. Like, I would love to put the Mania stuff in, but at the same time, it's like, first of all, they're at an angle, which wouldn't really work in this game. And second of all, the modern kind of emulates that. But I am trying to think of any other games that we could potentially get skins from. Any other famous, not famous, but any other classic examples of skins that we may want to put in here. I already got the Atari, and I think I might have two different versions of Atari Ghosts. We might do like the original Pac-Man Atari Ghosts and then the Miss Pac-Man Atari Ghosts, because I really like the way Miss Pac-Man on the Atari looks too. So I might do some stuff like that. Namco Museum sprites. What do you mean? don't know what that is. I don't know how those are different. The other thing is, it's like, Donnie, you sent all those images from Pac-Man Championship Edition. And I would love to put those in, but the problem is that they're too small. The sprites are actually too small for the size I need them to be. And that sucks. What am I doing here? I need flash. There we go. He's on the bottom, right? Okay, good. And this is 15. This is 15. I'm really paranoid about not getting these right. We're gonna name this Classic Eyes. Classic Eyes! I already did that joke, sorry. Okay, this one. Okay, you know what? I'm not gonna keep going back and forth. It's too annoying. But yeah, I've been trying to think of any other. I've been trying to think of what I could do. MSX sprites, I can sell my own custom. Yeah, I mean, MSX might not be a bad idea. I thought those ones were kind of like awful and gaudy, though. I thought we didn't like those. And I may be even able to do maze skins. So that may be a thing we can do too. I got to thinking about that, and it's like, if it's literally just a matter of changing a direction in the maze creator of what it's building, we could potentially just do that. So this is, we're gonna have to rename this now. Wait, did I put I and put the Angie in here? Oh, I don't have Angie yet. Okay, that's fine. We can work on that later. Let's go ahead and actually put these in here, though, as a reminder to myself to do it. Because if I don't do that, then I will probably forget. We can maybe do that tonight. The other thing I want to do is actually try to work on Cruz Elroy, get that in the game tonight. I want to try to implement, which should be super duper easy, the zones where the ghosts cannot go upward, or a certain direction depending on what we want. So I want to put that into, and then there's one last aspect of the ghost house that I think I need to work on, and that is for ghosts that are starting in the ghost house. So I need to have some sort of an indicator of a ghost is in the ghost house, and they need to act appropriately when they're in there. So we'll see about working on that too. All right, so we got all this C plus. This is, we're gonna do the normal, which these aren't too different. These are basically the same. I need to just do all this stuff after. I keep trying to change the animation frames and stuff. And it's not what we need to do. It's not the vibe. Now we go and do this stuff. Now we go and change everything once we have everything put in place. That way we don't have to flip between these tabs back and forth. And I don't think there's a keyboard command to flip between the tabs. These classy eyes remind me of a TikTok meme. If you have blue eyes, try the brown. Oh, that one, yeah. Wonder how it's all gonna play out whenever we get to importing maze generator code. Yeah, like I'm excited about the maze generator stuff, and I am not certain. So There are things that I want to tell you guys, but I'm scared to tell you guys because I don't want to get your hopes up in case I can't do them. Is my main thing. But I suppose I can probably tell you. So my plan right now is, and I have ways of being able to do it, but my plan right now is to essentially let you guys, once I get the maze generator done, once I get the maze builder done, all this other stuff, my plan is that I will give you guys the ability to create your own maze sets with your own rules and everything. So, like, you'd be able to have like a grid of the mazes you've created or the mazes that are in the game, and you could add ones in whatever order you wanted them to play in, select a palette for that maze set, and then you could even like select the rules for the game, like whether or not what the default speed is, what the default skins are, and so that, and even if it's like custom skins, you could do that too. So that way it would load in stuff. So basically the point of it is that you could essentially take, you could take this thing that you made, and it would put it like all into a folder potentially on your computer. You could take this maze set that you've made, and you could share it with somebody else. Like, you could give them the folder, and then they could put it into their thing, and they could load up the maze set that you've made, and they could play your own thing. That is essentially my plan with this. It's going to be a lot, and I don't know if I'm going to be able to make it all work. Like, I'm hoping I can. Did you just say you can shit? Can you, Donnie? Can you? I'm waiting. You know what? I need to go to normal, and I need to... Oh. Well, Exatron proves to us once again that yes, he can shit. Congratulations. I'm so proud of you. I've never been more proud. No other thing in your life has ever mattered as much as proving on stream in front of a few other people that you can shit. Yes. Perfect timing. Yep. Basically, oh, this is not, why is that not looping? Hello? What? That one's looping. These ones I need to get rid of. We can't have these other animations here. All right, I'm gonna finish the eyes animation, and then I'm going to rename this. We're gonna be C plus eyes, and then I'm gonna exit out. Click Team Fusion has this really bad habit. Like, you see these things here? These are all empty animations, because I've cleared out the things, but it doesn't, like, if I go down here and look at this, like, flash, you see how these are like empty boxes? You can't see it at all. The cup's in the way. I'm sitting here chatting this whole time, trying to show you this stuff. Look, okay. So you see these empty boxes that are down here in this corner where my mouse is? And there's only one box that's filled in for this because we only have one direction. But if we go up to these ones, because I deleted these animations off of here and I haven't clicked OK and gotten out of this animation, it keeps these boxes on here and it makes me mad. I don't like it. Anyway, so let's get these. Oh, I didn't realize it was going to restart everything. All right, that's cool too. This doesn't really matter. I'm just... Let's do it anyway. Okay, let's click okay. Let's click okay. Let's go back into it. I don't really want to save just yet because I'm afraid that this isn't going to work. I think it should work fine. I've got a plan. All right, so we're just going to go through the animations real quick just to double check. We got our normal. Normal has the Angies. Okay, we go down here. We've got blue, which is just two animations. Looping, we're good. We got flash, which is just two animations. Looping, we're good. We've got the eyes, which are each looping. Okay, good. We go into plus. We've got plus, plus Angi, plus Angi, and they're all looping animations. Good, good. We're all good there. We've got plus blue, which is looping and has the two frames, plus flash, which is looping and has the two frames, and then we've got our eyes animations. And these are all 50 and looping. Okay, good. I was looking at Pac-Man J2ME ROMs when I saw one of the files says Pac-Man mid. It said Pac-Man is mid. So it made you stick with the square eyes instead of circle. What are you talking about? On the, there's really many things I'm looking forward to besides the maze creation team, a few custom sounds, a few maze sets, and the ability to play with stats on the side. Yeah. Are you talking about like with classic? I tried to go round. I really did try to go round. Like, I struggled with this so much because there's almost only so much pixel room to do. And so it was like, I remember when I was building classic, I struggled with the top of the ghost so much. Like, it doesn't look like it's that big of a deal, but like, I don't know. Like, getting that curve just right is such a pain. Like, it's such a pain because I don't know, like, this shape is really hard to replicate in a higher, to make it look good. So I tried to go with the eyes being a mix between, these are like round but they're pixely, but I didn't want them to be like squarish, so I tried going around. But like, again, if I go like this, oh shoot, I can't do it like that. If I go like this and take these pixels off, for example, I'm gonna go back and we'll go back and look at it here in a moment. But if I do this, because I did initially have that, I don't like the way that looks. Like, I don't like it. And I can do like that. I think I initially tried this too, and that works. I did. There was a period where I had the eyes looking like that. And I just, I don't know, man. I didn't like the way it looked. I'm still not really fond of the way that looks. I don't know, what do you guys, if you guys think I should do that, I could go, actually, do I like that? Are we doing that? Am I doing this? You know what? That doesn't look bad. I don't know if I want to put this here, though. Like, should I put... I feel like that squares off the eyes too much. I think I like it better the other way. Rounder eyes look more natural. Okay, well, I mean, maybe we keep it this way then. I can go back and change the classic style. I don't mind. I wish I had an in-between color. Maybe I need like a thing that makes it look darker. Like this. Would this look better? Stand out more? I think the original, pretty good, doesn't it? You like this a lot. So that compared to that. Yeah, I guess that does look a lot better, doesn't it? Yeah, all right, fine. We're doing that. I guess we just decided on some new eyes tonight. Well, that wasn't in the plan. That wasn't what I was planning on doing, but I'm happy with it. Oh, no, I need these ones. Peedle-eedle-eedle-eedle. I like the peeds. No, you're fine. You're fine. Like I said, I'm happy if it's a general consensus and we enjoy things. That makes me happy. So we're going to have to do this. I think this was the direction that I had some struggles with. Hi, Quincy. Hi, baby. Oh, you gonna move away from me at the last second? I got you anyway. You're not gonna get away from me. Are you kidding me? You don't just get away from me. Who do you think you are? Quincers. I know. Alright, so what are we doing at the top? How did we do the top of the eye? Shoot, I keep going to the wrong side. What did we do? It actually kind of shortens the eye up a little bit, but it's not bad. I could just copy and paste this, you know, like, honestly, and I should. Is that right? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, okay. So we got that versus that. Yeah, I guess it does look a lot better, doesn't it? I felt like their eyes were too small, I guess. Like, if we go over here and look at, like, normal, it felt like their eyes were too small. You know? Thank you for the hydrate, Super Junior Pac-Man, with the pack. Going back to the first year of Pac-Man being released, they actually sold 100,000. They sold 100,000 Pac-Man arcade machines in the first year too, which is pretty crazy. The game actually was not popular in Japan. It became popular when it was released in the U.S. I think I can just flip this one, but I have to flip this eyeball. As weird as that sounds, I have to flip these. Is that right? Yeah, as long as everything else on there looks okay, we're good. Let's just go like this. we be spriting, yep. I wonder what Japan had interesting in at the time that kept Pac-Man. I just think they, I don't know. It is a curious question. They just like weren't interested in it really. I'm not really certain why. All right. I think if Pac-Man wasn't around, the world would be a very different place, as weird as that sounds. Like, I think we would still have video games, but they would be way different than they are now. Because Pac-Man literally was Pac-Man was literally like responsible for a lot of put that there. I don't like that being like that. Nope, I don't like that. It's supposed to be like that, but I'm not gonna do it. I'm gonna have to change all the classic frames too. Yeah, so the thing that made Pac-Man really different was that back when before Pac-Man came out, a lot of the games of the era were basically games that were like shoot 'em ups or space games or army games and stuff like that, like controlling tanks and like that's cool, but none of them really had any characters. So like Pac-Man is known as being one of the first games that actually had characters. Sorry, I'm concentrating. I'm trying to watch these two things and make sure I'm getting the sprites right. Pac-Man was one of the first games that had characters. And not only that, but Pac-Man was one of the first games that appealed to women as well. So back before Pac-Man came out, like most of like the whole reason that Pac-Man was created was because Toru Iwatani, the creator of it, looked in arcades back at the time when they did have just a bunch of when they had a bunch of the, you know, shoot 'em up games or army games, space games, stuff like that, and he saw a lack of women playing video games. It was mostly guys playing video games. And so he wanted to tap into that market of, you know, women playing video games. He wanted to get them included too, because it seemed weird that only guys were playing video games primarily. So he, like these little ghosts, he specifically made them cute and colorful in order to appeal to women, like, because most games back then, again, were, you know, very like bland colors and, you know, greens and stuff. They weren't really bright and they didn't pop a whole lot. So he specifically created Pac-Man to cater to and include everyone, but he kind of created a little bit to cater to women so that they could, you know, they could see the games could be fun too. And it was something that was, you know, unique and different. And again, it was one of the first games that had a character. Everything else just had generic things like spaceships and tanks and stuff. So, or paddles and Pong.
Hi, Gay.
Hi, Trashua. And so because of that, it took off. You know, Pac-Man took off. It became this... I'm about to change all the eyes animations. Fuck. No, I'm not. Because they're the way I had them. I'm gonna leave them. Yeah, see, these are more round. Look, that's how I initially had it. That's so funny. I never changed those. So yeah, because Pac-Man was so huge and because it was like a gaming phenomenon, it kind of propelled video games further than where they were projected to go. Because back in the day, a lot of people were thinking that video games were just a phase. They were some neat little technology that came out. It was a fun thing to do, but most people just didn't see a lasting appeal in them. And obviously, as technology went on, I'm sure that they would have found some sort of lasting appeal for them. Like, I'm sure that they would have. But back then, like I said, people just weren't seeing it as something that was valuable. And so I think without Pac-Man, we would actually be a little bit behind where we are now in terms of video games. That's my theory on it anyway, is that we actually, like, video games would not be where they are today without Pac-Man's influence, which I think is pretty cool. I'm glad you brought this to my attention, Donnie. Wasn't even something I was planning on doing, but I, you know what? I like the way it looks. And it's one of those things where it's probably like, I probably had them looking exactly like this before, but I don't know, something about seeing them back then, I probably just, I gotta move them down, fuck. The up is the hard one. The up is the hard one. Is that where they're supposed to be? Yes. This is the hard one. Not super hard, but a little bit annoying. Oh, let's see here. I'm gonna color this all in red. We are going to... Oh. I'm being kind of lazy. I could actually just resize these sprites down 50% and then rework on them so I don't have to do like these double pixels for everything, but I don't know, man. This actually isn't too hard. We'll get it. Yeah, Trasha, how you doing tonight, buddy? Hope you're having a good evening. Thank you for stopping in. Always appreciate seeing your face in here. Okay, so that's our standard eye, correct? I'm gonna grab one of these just to pull it up here and look at it. Why did you give them eyebrows for a moment? What are you talking about, like here? It's just supposed to be a, like, the shading of the curvature of the skin going in, essentially. I like the idea of a brand new toy you can play on your TV. I think the idea of a brand new toy you can play on your TV would be nuts, right? Random fun fact, did you know in Galaxian, the player is the Galaxian? In the original game, it says, we are the Galaxian, mission destroy all aliens. Oh, interesting, yeah. That is kind of weird because it's like you feel like the name of the game is. Where are we going? I gotta go over two. Okay, that's fine. I could put this here. Is that gonna be too much? I feel like I wanna have it. I feel like I want to have this here. I don't know, it just feels better. It's a spacer between. Okay, anyway. So, get rid of this one and just compare these. Okay. Get rid of those. And then for the... this direction over here, this is easy. I don't even need two, I just need one. We just take this and we just move it in 4 pixels. 1, 2, 3, 4. Because for some reason, Midway decided that having the ghost's eyes be 2 pixels or a pixel closer together. No, 2 pixels, yeah. For some reason, they decided that that would be better? I don't really understand. Goodbye, original classic sprites. They're smaller, but I feel they feel more natural. Yeah, you're right, it is one pixel. Let's see here. Okay, so we got these two are both. I gotta go make sure I went through all these and they're all correct. Okay, cool. So classic is officially changed. All right, so what were we working on? I can't even remember what we were working on. We got classic plus in here. Okay. So now we need to put auto in. Auto is what we need to do next. Fuck, I'm gonna have to rename all these. Shoot. What are you guys talking about? Raspberry Rallies, Toast Jays, and Samoas. Wait, what did I miss? Girl Scout cookies. Oh my god, Girl Scouts. I've never heard of Toast Yays and Raspberry Rallies. Raspberry Rallies sounds really good. Yeah. So I'm going to call these. I'm going to rename this as O Normal. Because I got to get rid of the other ones first before I can even do that. Rename this one to O Blue. O Blue! Rename this one to O Flash. And look at this, we've already basically cleared up a whole entire animation. Rename this to O Eyes. Okay. And these should be pretty easy. Right, why am I doing that? Yeah, auto was the original. Was the original Miss Pac-Man before it became Miss Pac-Man. Had these weird little dudes with weird little dudes with legs. Or with feet. And little antennas. It's hard to see the antennas here, but they have like little these little antenna thingies on the sides. Little bug apple boy. I know, right? That is exactly what they are. Thank you, Molly. little bug boys. Little buggy apple boys. Angy apple boys now. I want to show you guys something funny when I finish these. And how like my ghost house logic at the moment currently works. All right, let's make sure these are all 15 and looping. Flash. Get rid of these. Make this 15 and 15 and looping. Cool. And then we just need the eyes animations, which shouldn't be hard. Hi, Clancy. Quincy. Well, you want my lap? Is it lap time? Is it Quincy lap time? Oh my goodness. Hi, Quincy. Hey, Zap. It's going okay. We are working on some stuff, and I'm getting a cat in my lap. Yep. Getting the Quincy in the lap. Hi, baby. Hi. You gonna lick me? Aw, give me kisses. hope it's time to clean yourself. Okay. Feel free. Yeah, I need to copy this. How you doing tonight, Zap? It's good to see you. Yeah, I figured something out today at work thinking about this game because it's something I do when I'm having when I'm working on a game project. Like, it's basically like always in my mind, and I'm always thinking about things and how I can change things and how I can work on things, and I thought of a way to make things more efficient for myself and reduce the number of animations used. But it takes a lot of tedious work. So that's what we're doing tonight. We're doing all the tedious work. A lot of fun. Trying to make an economically cheap taco dish. I learned about trimming fatty cuts of meat. Oh. Yeah, it's a lot more work for me, but it is a good trade-off. All right, so now we need to change these ones to... We're gonna change this to Atari. I'm just gonna name it A for the moment. We'll go back and rename them later. Hi, Quincy. Oh, this is gonna line up perfectly. It's gonna line up perfectly, so I don't actually have to worry about That's nice. That's super nice. All right, we're gonna grab our normal sprite. And the nice thing about these ones, these are easy. I don't think I'm gonna do angry sprites for the Atari one. I don't know how I can really accomplish it. So, you know what? We'll just say it's limitations of the system. Isn't that right, Quince? Quince Mints. Thank you for the hydrate. Sniff it. Oh, I didn't mean to bonk you in the nose. You move forward. Maybe. What? I'm drinking. He always is so curious when I'm drinking. Super curious when I'm drinking, baby. Yes, you are. You wanna lick my hand? Aw, thank you, baby. Thank you. So nice of you. I always appreciate Quincy kisses. Yes, I do. I always appreciate the Quincy kisses. Yes, I do, baby. They give the sprite a different color. You know what? That's a good idea. That a Quincy kiss is a quiz. Oh no, I love that. Oh no, I love that. You know what? A different color is a really good idea, Donnie. A different color is a fantastic idea. That's actually a super duper good idea. I might use that. We can play around with that. It'll help differentiate Blinky from the rest too, yeah. Get a car sticker with Quincy's face on it that says, "Life short, have a quiz." You guys want me to angle the camera down so you can see the Quince? He's in my lap. If you guys want it, I will do it. You know, I will always give you the Quincy content. Even though I don't like angling the camera down because it makes me, why are you? Oh, you rubbing your face? Okay. It's a bad angle and it makes me look chonky. Right, I'm gonna save this real quick. All right, so we got that in here. We got all the Atari, Blue, Flash, and these are all proper, right? Okay, good. These all work. I'm actually gonna put these in here. That speed. Okay, and now we can move on to the NES stuff. Is this popcorn? I fucking love popcorn, man. Let me name this one too. N normal. This is gonna be the NES stuff. Right? I like the original popcorn song. I've always liked it. There was a game, and I don't even know what it was. I don't know what it was. Maybe it was like Mr. Do or something like that. There was a game that was on the original... Oh, baby. There was a game that was on a like PC a long, long, long time ago. And... and for some reason it was obviously a home version of an arcade game or something like that. But I think it had this song in it. What did happen to the Quincy Cam? So what happened to the Quincy Cam is that Linux's webcam that he uses for his VTuber model and stuff, it started going bad and he needed another webcam. And so the Quincy Cam, I just gave him the camera I was using for the Quincy Cam. So he is using it now. Blue. Man, this is actually really close. Because we're literally just using this thing here. If it was one more off, I could have just used these. That would have been nice. Yeah, I would like to think of any other skins. Oh, I did it right. Okay. I was worried that I didn't. Rename this one. I'll go back and rename them all once I really... Once I get it, because like I said, I can't have double animation names. It's kind of dumb. Why am I doing that? Oh no. This direction. I've been wanting to like work on this like all day. I'm so happy that I'm home and I can just do this. Holy shit, I'm so happy I can just be home and doing this. Crazy sometimes, right? Like when you're just like, all you want to do is just be home and you want to work on your shit. Okay, in eyes, flash, blue, has all of the animation directions we don't need. Save. Dig Dug Rally. I don't really want to put those in now. Like, I mean, it's not like it's impossible to do, but I'm just trying to think of any other prominent versions of Pac-Man. The only ones I can really think of are like stuff from Championship Edition. Like, just like the more stylized neon looking visuals. That's the stuff I can really think of. The ZX. Aren't those the horrible looking ones though? Hey, Super Junior Pac-Man. Can you send me the, get your ear flipped outside, Quincy. Can you send me the, was it the Mega Drive? Or not the Mega Drive. The, Philips CDI rights. I thought you said you had those. Gladly. I'm not saying we're going to put them in, but I'm just, I want to look at them. I want to look at them and see if it's something we want to put in. Imagine Pac-Land style. Oh, that'd be cute. A Pac-Land style would be really cute. I don't know how you would do it, really. But it would be cute. Wait, this is a... I have designed a 3D model of Pac-Man. I could animate it and have, then it could be used as a base to make a lower resolution sprite. I mean, it's always possible. We can always add things in. What is... What are you doing? You're just going ham on cleaning yourself right now, aren't you? Baby. Good boy. He's my good boy. Yeah. Yeah, he is. He is. Good boy. Very good boy. Oh, he's so full of purrs right now. He's so happy. He's got the bees. He's so happy. He's so happy. He is. So he's very full of bees. Yeah. I could put the microphone up to him, you guys would hear him full of bees. So I'm a little confused. I thought these are these the sprites you sent me, Super Junior Pac-Man, are these the ones from the Ms. Pac-Man game that like has all the really gross mazes that we talk about all the time? The ones with like the really long tunnels and stuff? What am I thinking of? I thought that was the CDI. These ones are basically just kind of an extension of the NES sprites. The MSX, no, the CDI ones, yeah. I was looking at these and I'm just like, these look very, they're cool, but they're just very similar. I like the maze style though. I really wish I could emulate that. Your sprite breaks the, yeah. I don't see, and that's another thing with like importing sprites. I don't know how Click Team Fusion handles that stuff, so we might have to try it just to see what it does. I have imported sprites before in Click Team, and I think you have to like, I don't know how it would be done. I'd probably make it so that you would upload the sprites and then it would save them on its own. Anyway, let's continue working on these. So we've got our auto, we've got our Atari, we've got our NES stuff in here. Next, we need to put the SNES in here. So we got NES. Again, I'm gonna have to rename all these. It's so annoying. I'm gonna SN just because, and then. The NES eyes. Yep. We got the NES eyes in there. Those weirdo looking eyes. I mean, I kind of like the way they look, if I'm being honest. It's strange, but I like it. Why do I keep doing that? Okay, once we get through these last two. Yeah, once we get through these last two, we should be able to, start working on implementing them and then deleting all the other frames. Be nice. There too. That's what I did. That's right. Okay. We're gonna call this one SN Blue. I really hate the way this blue sprite looks. I think it looks so fucking nasty. It looks so goddamn nasty. Who thought that was a good idea? Look at this, look, why you got the clown makeup on around the mouth? Like, why would you do that? Like, why, I don't like the way it looks. I think it looks gross. It's accurate, but it looks gross. This is gonna be SN Flash. And this one too, like, look at that. Nasty. We're gonna rename this one to be SN Eyes. These are weird looking too. And I don't know actually if I've got the positioning on these right, which is a problem. I kind of just took like a sprite sheet that I saw online for how they looked, but I don't know if it's accurate because when they're actually in the game, they're not placed properly in the Super Nintendo version. They actually go like down. It's really weird. They're like way in the stage where they're not supposed to be. Not 50 minus 50. Okay, save this. Yeah, you're probably right, Super Junior Pac-Man. That is probably completely and totally accurate. All right, so the last one we gotta do here. Last one we gotta do is, I'm just going to rename these to P2 for Pac-Man 2. Pack back in a hydrate. All right, let me get my hydrate on. You're good, baby. You can keep sleeping. It made me wake up the Quincers. It made me wake up the Quincers. It's fine though. Yeah, it's fine. He's a kitty, he'll be fine. You know what? You're right. I'm trying to think of your pack fact for that. Somebody can correct me if I'm wrong on this one as a pack fact, but I think the Namco Museum 50th anniversary collections or whatever it was that they had a while back was the last time that we had Pac-Man and Ms. Pac-Man together in a collection, like in a Namco Museum or any other Pac-Man collection. I think that's the last time that those two games were together. Which is sad, but I think it was. I'm trying to think of any other times when they've been together since then, and they really just haven't been. Battle Collection? What's Battle Collection? And I'm not talking about Pac-Man and Ms. Pac-Man, the characters, being together. I'm talking about the actual respective games. Like, actual Ms. Pac-Man and Pac-Man being together in a collection that works together. Because, like, typically, like, even on, like, arcade 1-Up machines and any compilations we have nowadays, you always get Pac-Man, you get Super Pac-Man, you get Pac-Man Plus, you get Pac-Mania, you get all these games together, but you never get Pac-Man and Ms. Pac-Man together in the same collection. Technically, Pac-Man Museum was the last. Which one was that one? Never mind, both released in 2005. Yeah, I feel like it's been a long time. But it was that whole era of Namco just doing whatever the fuck they wanted without having to worry about royalties and stuff. Which, I mean, good for them. I really kind of hate the colors on this. They're so... Like, look, there's actually two colors here. You can't even really see it because... Oh, look. These are... These are two different colors. Can't even see it. I want to improve it. To add to this, the last ever port of Ms. Pac-Man on consoles was the arcade game series in 2016. Yep, which I have and I love. This one I don't mind so much. Okay, and then we're just gonna make this next one be P2 eyes. Hope I got all these right. We're gonna have to go back and check everything. We'll just like run through the skins and do every single animation that they do. Make sure we got it all correct. Missed that one? Okay. Okay, so these are all looping. Flash is looping 1515. Blue is 1515. We got normal. And look at this, look at this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 animations I have saved myself that can be dedicated to something else. Can we fix that shading that's actually bothering me? I kind of want to. Like, don't get me wrong. I like it being accurate, but I also really hate it at the same time. Like, if this were me, I would lighten this up a little bit. About right there. Oh yeah, it's definitely fucking pillow shading. But that's what it should, I feel like it should be. Like, if we go like this and look at it in black, it still stands like that, but I feel like it's just, it's so, this is so gross. Look at it, it's so gross compared to this. That looks a lot better. I don't know. Like, I feel bad changing it because it's not accurate. Like, I took these colors directly from an NES emulator. But, man, I hate it. Man, I hate it. It looks so nasty. How nasty it is compared to this. The Flash looks okay. The normal looks okay. But the fucking blue, man, that looks so gross. What do you guys think? Should we change it? I feel like we should change it. I feel like we should change it and just say, oh, that's how the emulator was. It's still very close. I didn't lighten it that much. I just lightened it a little bit. Like, you could go even further and take it to, like, this range here. This would make it look a lot nicer. Like, that makes it look really nice. Compared to that. But I'm probably gonna stick with this just because this is, at least there's a visual difference between the colors at this point in time. My problem with the one that it originally was set to is that there's no fucking difference between the colors. And the problem with pixel art is that there needs to be a difference between the colors. Otherwise, why have two different colors? So, I think I'm going to change it. All right, we're going to click OK. I'm going to save this. I don't need this on anymore. Yeah, when you have a limited number of colors, use them wisely. All right, so now we can start getting rid of all these other animations we don't need. Really hope I got all this right, otherwise I'm gonna have to redo work. All right, Pac-Man 2 eyes, Pac-Man 2 flash, Pac-Man 2 blue, Pac-Man 2 normal. Just going back through and doing a double check on everything to make sure we got them all right. We got the NES or SNES Miss Pac-Man eyes, which are weird. I don't like how they bulge out on the sides, but whatever. We got the flashing animation. We got blue animation, and then we got the normals with the Angies. Okay, those are all there. We got the NES eyes. We already looked at those. NES Flash. NES Blue, NES Normals. Okay. Got the Atari Eyes. Got the Atari Flash, Blue, Normal. And we've got our auto stuff. Auto Flash, Blue, Normal. We got our Plus Eyes. That's right, we didn't change those. Look! Look with your Atari eyes! We got these with the brand new, the new eyes that we did. Classic normal. Okay, plus eyes here, plus flash, plus normals. All right, I think we're good. I think.
Hi.
I was thinking of getting CDI skins in there too, but nah, I feel it's a bit too much of an effort. I mean, that's what I was asking you for, was the CDI skins. At the moment, I have plans, Raspberry, to put Maze skins in there. That will not be something you can do with custom. That will not be customizable. Because it's just too many pieces. But I do have plans to have Maze skins in the game. I don't know. The flashing animation, too many frames. For the CDI. What was the other one I was gonna add? Oh, never mind. It's the pack. It's the Arrayus. Well, I would probably, in any of these skin things, I would probably condense them down to be closer to what they are supposed to be. I'm trying to get the water bottle, Arrayus. I've got a Quincy in my lap. Yeah, we do. Got that Quincinator. Got that Quincinator here in my lap. Oh, did I drip on you, baby? I'm sorry. It did, didn't it? Yeah, we drip stuff on him. Ezekiel with the derp. I know, the derp eyes. I hate it. What was I gonna do? All right, let's go back through here and name all of these. I'm gonna rename these. We're gonna rename this one. Auto. Let's rename all of these autos. Let's start from the bottom since it seems to be doing this. Ow. Quincy, why'd you fucking scratch me? Fucking out, Quincy. He wanted to move forward a little bit, Molt. And so he basically put his claw in my pant and tried to pull himself forward just a little bit, but he didn't realize that his claw in my pant leg was actually in my freaking skin, and it hurt. He was trying to use me as a grip to move forward, and I did not like it. I I don't know how this is gonna actually affect. I just thought of this. I don't know, I shouldn't have deleted those animations. I shouldn't have deleted all those animations. I don't know how that's gonna affect the coding. Hope it didn't mess anything up. I really hope it didn't mess anything up. That's gonna suck if it messed some stuff up. I'm not gonna save. Let's go check before I go. All right, let's. Visual changes. Okay. Okay, these. We can get rid of these now. Plus normal. Yeah, we can get rid of those. So this needs to be NES eyes. NES blue. Nope. Oh man, these all gotta be changed. That's fine. Blue, this is NES flash. Okay. This is the Atari stuff. We're gonna do needs to be Atari normal. This is gonna be Atari blue, I think. I don't know what this was initially. Let me go to the frame over here. What is this? Blue is playing plus. Why would I do that? Oh, I know why. Never mind. I know why. Yeah. Atari normal, this should be not Atari blue, this should be Atari flash. This one should be Atari blue. Atari flash down here. It'll also be Atari flash, it's fine. I don't really need this, do I? We'll test it out. Atari eyes. This is supposed to be, Quincy, don't. You guys stop trying to move yourself. Use your back legs. Use your back leggies. Use your back leggies, baby. And push yourself up. No.
Stop. Get your claw out of my leg.
Stop doing that. He's gonna kill me. These are all Atari eyes is playing. Okay. Angry. We don't need that. Okay. Yeah, we don't need this one anymore. The angry one. We're gonna change these to. This is gonna be Atari eyes. And these are just changing the directions. The Atari has some special coding just because of, as of what it is. So, we don't need this. Stopped. This is SNES. SNES normal. Oh, see, it just says animation 47, 48. Yeah, even though those aren't there anymore. Okay. Blue. SNES Flash. SNES Eyes. Flash. Blue. And SNES. And then this one, we're going to get rid of this again. See, look, I'm saving myself events, Quincy. I swear to God, if you do it again. Pac-Man 2 normal. Pac-Man 2 blue. Pac-Man 2 flash. And Pac-Man 2 eyes. Oh, what are you doing, Quincy? You little weirdo. All right, he's done on my lap now. No, he was not trying to make biscuits. I don't mind when he makes biscuits. Biscuits are cute. He was most definitely not making biscuits. So I want to do something here real quick. I want to go up here, put in the testing section. We're going to make a new event that's going to say, upon pressing S, what we're going to do, and we're going to say, add a new condition. Do four. I'm gonna say, grab this again. Is lower than four. Then what we're gonna do is we're going to, same thing with like level here. We're going to, add to a global value. The skin style, one, and then we're gonna restart the frame. But we're gonna do another event here that's gonna say, is equals four. Then we will change a global value. Set skin style to zero and then restart. Right, let's see if this works. All right, we put all that work into these things. Let's see if it paid off. Let's hit S. Okay, we went to Atari style. Hit S again, we've got NES style. S again, we got the SNES Miss Pac-Man style. And then this is, oh, that's what I figured would happen. That is what I figured would happen. The last one we want is the Pac-Man 2 style. So I can't do either one. Do I have a buffer or something? Let's just do this. I'll just use this for now anyway. Okay, so now we should be able to, there's the there we go, that's the SNES. There, see, it still looks good. Like, it still looks like the SNES one, but it doesn't look quite as horrible as it was before with the colors being. Okay, so I like that. That looks good. What the thing I wanted to show you guys, which is really funny, is that because of the way that I programmed the ghosts to function, like, if I move Blinky here, for example, he recognizes that that is his spot in the ghost house. So he goes over there and he does that. So he stays on that side over there. That's where he stays. Likewise, if I put him over here, he'll do the same thing on this side. So it's wherever, it's wherever they start at, their X position is wherever they go into. So we can even do something like this, and we can even have them be in this little spot here instead. So they can really just kind of be anywhere. So you can even, like, this is what's funny. I could even put him over here as a starting thing. He's probably going to go through the wall. He is. But if I hit E, he will go into the ghost house and go all the way over here. And then he will bounce up and down there because that's where he thinks his exposition is. And then when it's time for him to leave, he'll go all the way over here and then go out. That's not something that we're really gonna have to worry about when the game actually, that we're, is actually gonna happen during the game. Hi, Rod! How's it going? But I just find it amusing more than anything. Let's put him delicious. Tasty. I kinda have to pee. Wow, that took 2 hours? We've been going at this for 2 hours and all I did was that? A lot. And then, yeah, I've got these slowdowns. So, like, we could put these, I can just paint these in. We could put them, like, here, just as an example. So if we paint these in here, and then test out Blinky now, if he goes through this area, he's going to slow down. So, slowdowns are kind of cool. Got those implemented. What I need to do next is we need to implement the 384 by 280 for the CDI screen size. Why are the graphics? I don't know. I don't know what you're looking at, Super Junior Pac-Man. I don't know. If it's not something that we can make work, then we don't really have to worry about it too much. Oh my fucking god. Buff Miss Pac-Man. I just saw your message in the Discord, Corellian. Funny. Give me a moment. I'm going to go pee real quick. I will be right back.
Oh.
And just hoping, babe. I'm gonna get back to streaming. No!
I can. Alright. Not in time. Oh, I see it. Yeah, I see what you're talking about. All right, let's change our goal, because we did what we wanted to do. I need to make the angry stuff happen, but we'll work on that in a moment. For right now, also, Rod, how you doing today? I didn't ask you. I hope that your day is going well. You're going back home here soon, aren't you? Rod's on like a big long vacation from work, and I am jealous, but also super duper happy for him. What are we gonna be working on next? Tomorrow morning getting on the train. I wanna go on a train. Trains sound fun. Trains are like just as expensive as a freaking plane ticket is, though. What I always heard in the past. Maybe it's not. I don't know. Is that true? How was it pricey or was it pretty decent? We are going to This should be easy. I accidentally overwhelmed myself today trying to learn new stuff, so I'm slowing down and trying to set a game plan for myself. Hey, Talk, how's it going? You what? He should just come over here, but yeah, we should probably go see him.
A train.
Let's see here. So, plane ticket right now are actually kind of high, so it was cheaper. Coach seat was like $80, but I decided to treat myself and get on a train that has a private room. Ooh. That cost me $300, but I think it'll be worth it for privacy and comfort. Yeah, no kidding. That's incredible. That sounds awesome. Okay, so what we're gonna do here, we need to create a new... I'm gonna actually just use this. Clone object. We're gonna make a new... I gotta do this. This is something I'm very curious about. Maybe this is a weird thing where it likes to snapshot the default screen option rather than the screen size. Okay, yeah. I think we would just have to have them here. We're gonna call this no pass up. And I think when I did these in actual Pac-Man 37, let me open that up here. Yeah, I did these right here. So the up one is with a little G on it. And I did that for ghosts, and then I have some for fruit as well. It limited certain areas that the fruit could go. I might just use these same colors again.
Oh.
Put a. We put a. What do you mean, no?
Playing with things you're not supposed to. It's him.
Right? Doesn't look right. It needs to be one more over, doesn't it? Yeah, it does. It's like, I knew something was off. Garlic shrimp is garlicking. Upgee. So, this should be pretty easy. This should be pretty easy. What we're gonna do is we're gonna put these in these positions here where he cannot pass upward. Did I make the hotspot the same? Okay, hotspot's the same. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to ghost movement here. This should be pretty easy. I'm actually just gonna get rid of that. And then we're also going to paste this, but we're gonna say this is what I needed to do. So what I want to do here, I forgot about this. I need to go to each of these. We need to make a new altable value here that says erection. And we'll set this one to 0, 1, 2, and 3. And then we'll do this. Insert a new, add a new condition. Pair one of the alterable values, direction equals 0. Then we will do that. Okay. Now he should not be able to go up. Like if we bring him down here, for example. Yep. Okay, he's ignoring the rules. All right, what? I need to turn these things back on again. Gonna copy the whole thing. Make visible at the start, and then what we're also going to do is we're going to. I've been wanting to do this for a little bit anyway. Up is green. I want to make this like a darker color. I would make it red, but at the same time, it's like his stuff is already red, so. Dang it. Hello? There we go. Let's also go over here and we're going to reduce the speed down to like 100 just so I can see what's happening here. Oh, I reduced Pac-Man's speed, not the ghost speed. Whoops. It still says green. So why? X position plus Y position equals the same thing as that. Were the names chosen for the rhymes, but also to hint at their movement actions? So, and this is going to be kind of your pack fact here, Super Junior Pac-Man. I apologize, I missed it. But yeah, in the original arcade game, let me see here, because I can't remember their actual names from the Japanese version. Well, let's see here. So, in the Japanese version, let's start over. In the US version, they are named weird. So it's Blinky, Pinky, Inky, and Clyde. But then they have nicknames on there too, which is only ever in Pac-Man. They never use nicknames again anywhere else. But Blinky, the red ghost, his nickname is Shadow. Which sort of makes sense because he's always basically trailing you. He's like your shadow. He's always going to be after you. But here's where things get a little weird. Pinky's nickname is Speedy, indicating that she's fast. But she's not faster than any of the other ghosts. Inky, the blue ghost, his nickname is Bashful, which means that would indicate to me that he's shy, but he's not. He works alongside Blinky. And then the orange ghost Clyde, his nickname is Pokey, meaning he's slow. But again, he's not slow. He's the same speed as all the other ghosts. If you look at the Japanese translations of the ghosts' names or their nicknames, Blinky's is Chaser, which obviously again makes sense, similar to Shadow. He chases you. He's pretty much always right on you. Pinky's nickname is Ambusher, which makes sense. That's what she does. She's always trying to get four tiles ahead of Pac-Man, whereas Blinky's always trying to get right on top of Pac-Man. So together, they work to chase and ambush. Inky's nickname is Fickle, which that makes a lot more sense for Inky because Inky is always trying to find a tile that's basically between Pac-Man and Blinky. So, simply put, so if Blinky is closer to Pac-Man, Inky will be more aggressive. But if Blinky is further away from Pac-Man, then Inky will be less aggressive, essentially. And then Clyde. Clyde's translation from the Japanese name is feigned ignorance. Which, again, also makes sense. Because, feigned ignorance makes sense because Clyde will chase you until you get close to him. And then when you're within a certain range from him, he will run away. But as soon as you get out of that range, he chases you again. So the ghosts are 18 by 16. Ugh. 10 frames of animation. Why are they so wide? I mean, if I'm being honest, I probably wouldn't use all 10 frames. You know, I don't know. I mean, I guess we could. Just be kind of weird. Oh yeah, the other way around. Yeah, Blinky, Pinky, Inky, Clyde are the nicknames. Yeah, the other way. But that didn't stick past the first game. Direction equals zero. I guess we're gonna have to do this. Let's increase the speed a little bit so we can do things, we can see things in a better light here. Let's get rid of Pac-Man, we don't need him on here. Let's go with our Blinky Logic up. Alterable values. Right now he can't move up. So right now it's set to 10,000 because it's colliding with a wall. In the next frame, it is also set to 100,000 because it's colliding with a wall. And this one here, it's set to 32, yeah, because he's right next to it. Why is it not ignoring this? This stuff is, yeah, especially when they don't really even look that different, if I'm being honest. They have a little bit of a difference, but the white is really the only thing that matters, I can see that matters. Weird. What is going on here? What if we change this to 2? I just want to see something here. Still green. It is not being affected at all by this. I don't... Yeah, that doesn't matter. That shouldn't matter. As long as it's overlapping that, it shouldn't... I don't really want to do an overlap because I'm trying my best not to do any sort of overlapping stuff. By the way, Bosk, the original game handles this by setting that zone above the ghost pen and preventing it from updating its direction. Only reverses are allowed to be used. Yeah, for me, creating a custom engine where I want to allow people, or I want to allow myself to be able to put in blockades in the future, if I want to, I don't want to handle it that way. I just want to basically make it so that... that if it touches that, it says no, you can't do this. It basically acts like a wall. Oh, but I just thought of something. I can't do this actually because I'm gonna have to make this a specific event. I'm gonna have to make each one of these a specific event. We're gonna have to do this. Check distance is on, plus I don't even need the direction on there, but I do need to say on here plus compared to one of the alterable. No, we need to go animation, which animation is playing. We're gonna say walking is playing. We're gonna put that there. I'm gonna have to do these individual for each one, as much as I wish I couldn't, but I have to differentiate when let's see if that actually works. I don't know if that's even gonna work. Well, let's see here. So if he gets over here, it still marks it as green. Why? Why are you marking that as green? Hotspot's the same. Could you add custom tiles that act as blockages? That way you can set up restriction zones in the maze period. Yeah, that's what I planned on doing, was going to be allow people to do that, to put like these no pass zones things wherever they want to put them. Why isn't this working? Am I missing something here? Exposition of that equals X of that. Y position equals that's, unfortunately, that's gotta be custom coding. As much as I hate to say it, because I can't just create those. I can't just create them and put them there, because then the ghosts would never be able to go down at any point in time. There has to just be a custom coding, unfortunately, that says they can't go that way. I'm not certain. I imagined this was going to be easy, and it's not easy for some weird reason, and I'm not certain why. I don't know why this is being difficult. No, it's, I had to do custom coding. It's like I said, it, you have to think about it. Like, think, imagine you're on the left side of the maze, and you have a ghost coming out of the tunnel, and they want to go down, but they can't. So we create a little object here that says they can't go down. But what if you have another ghost that just so happens to be coming toward the tunnel and wants to go down, and that object is there? Now all of a sudden they're limited and they can't go down, even though they're not the ones who went through the tunnel. It was the other ghost that came through the tunnel. So again, it's probably pretty rare that the two of them would be there at the same time, but it can happen, and I don't want that to be a thing that happens when it's not accurate. Anyway, why? Let's try something here. I'm gonna replace this with. Let's see, you are right in my way. Yes, you. I see you. I don't want to do this. Let's see if this works. It still gives it the green. Oh, it didn't. Does this give the green? I didn't actually pay attention. It looked like it was green. Yeah, it still gives... Why does this not work, but overlapping works? I mean, it could be, but it's so niche to do, you know? Like, I could put it in there, but it's just like, it's such a weird feature that it's only used on one maze. I don't know why we'd want to keep it, but I guess we could. I mean, I could make it a programmed feature. I mean, actually, now that I'm thinking about it, that might be... That might be the way we handle... That might be the way we handle this. No. I actually don't mind that. That's not a bad idea. But I'm trying to think of how I handle this. What if I made this 64? Did I get that right? Yeah, okay, I did. It still doesn't matter. Actually, I don't like that because that doesn't... No, I mean, we could do... Yeah, that might work, actually. Hang on. Let me see if I can do this. Now, let's make these flags. Make these flags. 2, 3, 4... group, do they make a qualifier group for these? I think I'd rather do that, make them a target group. Let's try something else here. I'm gonna put that there. We're gonna say, replace this with. I don't really like doing collisions, but collision overlapping another object. No pass up. Plus, place this with. Oh wait, that's right. I couldn't do qualifiers because of this thing. Why does this matter? I don't even need that there, I don't think. I don't think I can make this work. But that's fine. That's fine. Let's get. Okay, we're gonna set. I'm actually gonna get rid of that. I'm going to go flag set on. Up blocked is on. Let's. I'm trying to think how I'm gonna do this. Okay. How about we just do this? That is overlapping that, plus add a new condition. Get one of the alterable values. Direction equals 0. That up blocked on. Oh, wrong one. And then what we're going to do here is copy this, I think. We're gonna say check distance is on. Plus direction equals 0. And add a new condition. The flag is a flag on. A blocked is on. And we will flag set off. I'm gonna have to make it small again though, I think. I can't have it be that big. This is gonna be 32. This will be 14. Why are you both beeping at me? I'm thinking. Oh, they're unhappy. I gotta take care of them. Got to take care of the Tama babies. I will get you hydrate in just a moment. Stop it. Okay. Let me get the hydrate in. I think I have an idea for your pack back, but let me just see something real quick here. Hang on.
Well done. You're one of us. Come in, sit down.
Okay, yeah, that's what I was thinking. I just wanted to verify, because it's not something I see very often. But the pack fact I was going to give you is that in Super Pac-Man, Super Pac-Man has four cutscenes that happen, I think. Whereas pretty much every other Pac-Man game only has three. Like Pac-Man, Ms. Pac-Man, and Junior Pac-Man all have just three cutscenes, but Super Pac-Man has four. I want to see something here. See if this works. Okay, it seemed to work. Yeah, I don't really play Super Pac-Man either. Okay, so this, what I just did here, and what I'm actually a little happy about this, is because I basically just solved that issue for the Ms. Pac-Man maze. And what I mean by that is that all I have to do is turn on a flag now, and they can't go down until down is an option, I think. Is that right? Yeah, the next time down is an option, they cannot move down. So, and we can do this for all of them, actually. We can just do this here. We're going to say left blocked. We'll make this one. Two, and this is down blocked. We're just gonna edit this down blocked, and then this one should be, this is right blocked. Now let's say, for example, no, Super Pac-Man is definitely not my favorite either. Let's go to testing here. And I am just basically going to hit a new... Let's make a new keyboard command. What should we make it be? I don't care. Let's make it... W for wall or something. What I'm going to do here is go to this thingy. And we're going to go flag... set on down blocked. So if I go over here now and we put his thing here and I hit W here, oh yeah, anywhere down is an option, yeah, see, he can't move down. Even if there's nothing there. So these things essentially are just gonna act as little blockers that when he gets to that intersection, he can't move that direction. But with the Ms. Pac-Man maze, I can make a specialty thing that says, you know, when they get there. Yeah, I don't know why the ghost house is so big there. Okay, well that's cool. So we got that working. And we can do the same thing. We need to make four of these then. So this is no pass up. Let's clone this. We're gonna put these over here. Just so we've got them over here. We're gonna clone this. And make this a... What color did I use? In Pac-Man 37. It's not even that big of a deal. I just, for some reason, it's like, I could just use these same colors, right? Did it wrong again. This is going to be no pass left. Clone object. This will be no pass down. Definitely doing these things differently than how we did before. This one will be right. Right, I had being this color. Flip that. And then down, I had being a purple color. Ghost movement. We can go down here and we can look at this stuff here. This will be, that is overlapping side one. I need to move these around. It's gonna bother me. Put that there. And this would be one. Down. Two. Down blocked. This would be this way. Three. And right blocked. So, we could just kind of play around with these for right now, and we can... put a no pass right here. We could put a no pass left right here. And put one up here. Put a no pass right here. So they should be able to get out of the ghost pen, but they won't be able to get back in unless they come in from the top. So like if I put... this down here. See, he can't get in there. He's gonna try. He wants to, but he can't get in there. Hope you liked your sprite. Yeah, it was cute. Thank you. So these little thingies are just basically blocking him off from being able to go in any of these directions. That's awesome. That's a much more efficient way of doing that. And just because it's a flag, I can basically just turn, like for the Miss Pac-Man maze, for example, all I have to do is say, like here, I'll show you for an example. Where is it? Overlapping this thingy. So we're gonna say when he's overlapping that, we're just gonna say flag set on, down blocked is on. So like if we go over here and let's move our little blinky thing over into the side tunnel, right? So he's gonna go into the side tunnel, but then we're gonna say it's here. Oh, he still moved down. Okay, so that didn't work how I wanted him to. It worked, but it's not working here. For some, like, if I actually put the object in front of there, it would work. Like, for example, if I put the down block right here, and he goes into the side tunnel. Actually, let's just put it here, so we can test that a little bit better. And put it here. He can't move down. He's gonna go past. But I have to figure out why it's not working when I just set the value. I think what I can do here is let's get rid of that. Active objects. Let's look at Blinky Goal. See, I don't understand what's going on here. It should be... I've literally got an event here that says down set down blocked on. Oh, I know what it is. I know exactly what it is. Okay. Let's go just copy this. Let's get rid of all those. Actually, no, we want these to be on. And then this is just a test flag set on down blocked. Here we go. Now I betcha if I play this stage, take the blinky thing over here. He goes in the side tunnel and we move this down here. Yeah, he can't move down. Okay. So yeah, now he can't move down. Yep. So that's a pretty easy fix then that we can do. And yeah, we can just basically... now I can exploit this to my benefit. I could make it so that... I could make it so that the side tunnel thingies themselves have flags on them. Oh, not help. So we can do that. We can put a new event here, which we're gonna say insert. Now again, I'm just gonna copy this. It's easier. Shit, I didn't mean to do that there. I went through this one. We're gonna say man, I'd have to do that for each one of those. Oh, or can I put these things in a qualifier group? I have so many qualifier groups. It's ridiculous. I don't usually do this many qualifier groups, but I'm kind of enjoying it a little bit because it helps make the coding so much easier. What can I do a qualifier group on this one? This one would be, what do we call this? buttons, indicators, cursors, shields, movable interface. I want this to be something important. Indicator. I think that's what I used before, but I used that for a lot of the scene stuff, so I don't really want to use that here. No logic one or anything in here. Guess we'll just make it movable. Whatever. We're just gonna say oh, I can't do this. Fuck. Oh my god, Tamagotchis. You guys are so obnoxious right now. Because that means I also have to do the things for that too, and I haven't done that. Have I done anything with this? Does this have any alterable values? Last X, last Y, nuked space. This could be, let's do, that doesn't matter, does it? Oh, yeah, it does. Yeah, it does. Yeah, it does. Game startup. Set. Ghost ID to fixed value. Okay. Then we can go down here and we can say movable object is it, but we're going to say, we're going to put a new thing in here. We're going to say plus compared to one of the alterable values, ghost ID equals fixed value. Oh, that's not that. I want enemies. Fixed value of that. Plus then we're going to make this do our movable. But wait, we haven't indicated our target thing. How do we do that down here? Okay, that's too much. I think that's too much. Man, I really don't want to make like a bunch of fucking events for this stuff. I really don't want to make a whole bunch of events for this stuff, but maybe I need to. It shouldn't be too hard. Hang on. So what do we do? Okay. This is what's called scoping. And we need to say add a new condition plus flag. Is the flag on? Up blocked is on. I don't know if this will even work. I don't know if this is even gonna work. Flag set on. I have no idea if this is gonna work. This is a lot. This is like more scoping than I've ever done. Thank you for the hydrate. All for this, which is not something we would even really be using, I don't think, most times, but let me try this here. We're gonna go like this. We're gonna put go slow down. I'm gonna put a new one here, for example. Okay, we're gonna put one right here. Actually, no, I'll put it in here in the block beforehand, and I'm going to go like this and make up block turn it on. Okay, let's see if this works. That should prevent him from going up right here. Okay, it did. Yeah, he cannot go up there. He can go back down. He can't go up. Yeah. So, and the same thing, like if we make him go over here and then put this out here, he cannot. Oh! What happened? Buddy. How did you do that? How did you do that? How did you do that? I know exactly how. Okay, I know what happened. Okay. I know exactly what happened. No, so what the problem is here is that the blockage, there needs to be an order of priority. There needs to be an order of priority. So, do we make it so that the opposite direction takes priority over a block? Or do we make it so that the block takes priority over reversal? I think if I'm going by the mobile game, the mobile game has a lot of little blockades, like invisible barriers all around the mazes sometimes. And I see the ghosts do a 180 a lot of times when they hit the blockades. So that means that reversals should be considered less. So it needs to be 1 point less. So, let's try this again. I bet you he won't go through the wall this time. Okay. Why are you going all the way down there? Get up here. Yep, now he can't go through the wall. Okay. But that does present a problem here that No, not really. I think that fixes that problem. But anyway, my point here was that we were going to... We go over here, and he comes out. He can't move up. He's going to have to go straight through. He can move up now. Watch this. He's going to loop around. He's going to come back down. He's going to go back in here. He's going to bounce back out, not be able to go up, move all the way around. Yeah. So we've made it so that these tiles, the slowdown tiles, can hold information on where ghosts can go once they come out of the tunnel. So just by turning a flag on, now I can turn it off. But like if I say, down blocked, I don't even need this here anymore. If I have down blocked on those little tunnel pieces, and I put it here now, he will not be able to move down when he comes out. He has to go across. So that's easy. I have no idea what kind of a taxing system or anything that does on... I have no idea how taxing that is on the processing and everything like that, but I feel like it's easier, you know, like it's less coding, which is nice. Like we have so little coding in here now. This is all this stuff. Gosh, like it's just, to me, it's crazy. It looks like a lot, but we're like 38 to 101. So about 60 events, a little over 60 events, and we've got all of the ghost's basic movement. I don't know, it's a weird thing. I don't even know why they did it. Like it's one of those things, it's like, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me why they even created that as them not being able to come out or go down when they came out of the side tunnels. Like, I don't get it. But now that we have this in here, we can literally just, and you could make it like individual. Like it, could it, could you? Yeah, I could. Like you could create one and then set the flags or whatever you wanted it to be for the slowdown. So like each tunnel could have individual slowdown things on it. Well, I mean, it's not so much weird that... you're right. The home ports that GCC actually did. It could have been a bug. You're very right. Definitely could have been a bug. Is there any other maze in Ms. Pac-Man where the side tunnel is that close to the edge of the map? I don't think there is. That may be the bug itself. Like, if we go over here and we look at Ms. Pac-Man mazes... This is a shitty fucking screenshot, but whatever, I don't care. iOS for some weird reason. Why is she upside down? What? Anyway, I don't care. No other maze has the tunnel with no gap. Or with no spacing. Like this one here, there's what? There's one... Well, one is obviously the default. There's one, two tiles. This one is one, two tiles. This one is one, two tiles before they can move down. This one has no tiles. So it definitely could be a bug that the original programming... where the original programming just doesn't know how to handle ghost movement when they come out directly out of it. Remember the 256 bugs where they can't change the direction upon reaching the edge of the screen? There we go. Yeah, I think that's what it is. They can't change direction directly after coming out of a tunnel. That's interesting. See, that definitely would have been just a part of the programming of the original game. So now it's like a matter of... Now it's a matter of, do I need all that stuff there? I mean, I like having that stuff for the tunnels, but do I need that stuff there? Or is it a matter of I just make it so that when they come off the edge of the screen, they can't go up or down? Or they can't change direction until they've at least gone another tile in. Yeah, I think I'm gonna keep it in just because it's in there now and it's not taking up a whole lot, so it's fine. It's gonna be a feature that most people aren't going to use in the Maze Creator, but it's there. You know what? It's there. It's fine. Yeah, I could just remove it from the Maze Creator and it's not gonna affect anything in here. Alright, so I did that. I think the next thing I wanna do is put in Cruz Elroy mode. Let's do another thing here where we're gonna say upon pushing the C button. And then we're gonna say, do I have, how do I do this sometimes, man? Okay, I don't need normal Pac-Man 37 open right now. This thing? I think we need... Let's just set this to like 50 right now. Now, I have to have something in here. I have to have a flag in here. I think we have to have two more flags. We have to say Elroy 1, then Elroy 2. Should we do that or should we just create another value? I think a value would be better in this situation. Elroy mode. Okay, let's do that. And we're going to say... one of the alterable values. We're going to say Elroy mode equals 0. We will... set Elroy mode to 1. Actually, we're not even gonna do that. We're just gonna do this. We're gonna the value add to Elroy mode 1. That buffer there. Then we're going to put a new event here that's gonna say alterable values, if it equals 3, we will just, oh, I like the way that it looks in reverse. That looks very nice. Alter value set, Elroy mode to 0. So Did I get Elroy's speeds in here? So I'm post order. I don't think I did. I wasn't planning on this stuff yet. Ghost order. Hang on, that's not right. What is that? Oh yeah, we put that over here. So what is this one? That's 3, 6, 8, 12, 15. 18, 21. Is that right? We do dots first and then the speed. Right, dots two. We're going to set the Elroy one speed to shit. This should be 24. This will be Elroy two speed. This should be 30. Okay. All right. And I need to do the same thing here as well. Set counter to stage. I always thought if I ate the last power cookie or a special amount of cookie, Blinky gets angry, and Mega Mix showed me I could have been it could have been a specific amount, that amount being 10 or 15. The mobile app on PC officially and not. Yeah, so like the mobile app is really weird, especially when it comes to Cruz Elroy. Like, so the mobile app is weird to me. I don't know what they're thinking a lot of times. But, like, they have these events. Like, they have an event going on right now for Valentine's Day, which is cool. I like the event. They have 45 stages, which is a lot of stages to go through. And each one of them is a different maze. And that's neat. That's pretty cool. My problem with it is that every single maze, for some reason, they decide to have it be, a slow speed, which is fine for mobile, I get it, because it's hard to control on mobile. But B, they usually only have either Blinky or Pinky in the maze. And that's it. Like, it's just the two of them. It's just two of them. And it's like, it's weird to me that it's like, why would you just have two in the maze at all times? Occasionally, Inky will come into play, and you'll have Inky in the mazes. So you have three ghosts to deal with. But I swear to you, they rarely ever put Clyde in there. Clyde is, like, never to be seen. Clyde is never seen in the mobile mazes. Like, well, in the event mazes, excuse me. He's never seen. They just don't put him in there. And it's really fucking weird to me. It's very, very weird. So what we're gonna do here for testing, we're just turning Elroy mode on. We're not worrying about the dots or anything like that. We're just adding one to Elroy mode. And what we're gonna do is go back to the movement thing here. Should I put this at the top or at the bottom? I think it's really gonna come down to when Pac-Man eats a dot. No, it's not even the Valentine's thing.
Oh.
It's not even the Valentine's thing. It's like literally if you were to play the Christmas event, Clyde was never around. The Halloween event, Clyde was never around. Like, they just don't put him in there. I think it's because they don't want it to be too easy for play or too hard for players, I guess, or something. It's really weird to me because they give you lives. They give you like 45 days to finish these events. So it's not even really hard if you just do it. You can just barrel through. And it's so weird to me that they just don't put Clyde in there, like, ever. He's just not included. I can probably move these around, but I'm just going to put them up here at the top right now. Add a new event that's going to say... Where are the alterable values? We're going to say... Elroy mode equals 1. Plus, add a new condition. We're going to say, compared to one of the alterable values, current speed is different than... Oh shit, you know what? I put Cruz Elroy on him? Hang on. What am I doing here with these values? Order start X, start Y, Cruz Elroy. Man, I hate putting these down here. If I'm gonna have to. I thought I did these up above. I guess I didn't. Game startup. Forgot to do this here though too. Set current speed. You know what? Let's not do that. This is going to be set Elroy 1 speed 2. Okay. And then we're going to go down here. We're going to say add a new condition. Here we go. Here one of the alterable values. It's going to be current speed is different than Elroy 1 speed. And we're going to set current speed to Elroy 1 speed. Do the same thing again here. If this equals 2, plus current speed is different than Elroy 2 speed. And we are going to set his current speed to Elroy 2 speed. Okay, hang on. We got to do something different, though. We got to say add a condition plus animation. Which animation is playing walking? Let's fudge these around. I'm just going to do this just for the testing purposes here. Okay. we need to figure out the... Imagine a Pac-Man cabinet that had a mobile games level, but they changed depending on the day of the week or something, like weekly challenges. So I initially thought about doing something like that with Pac-Man 37. I initially planned, but of course I didn't know how to make it work back then because I would have had to make mazes specifically for this stuff. But I had initially planned on having a daily challenge in Pac-Man 37 where every day there would be a new maze and like new mechanics. Not every day would be new mechanics, but it would introduce neat things. Like I had an idea for like poison dots, like certain dots that would be like green in color. And like you couldn't eat those or it would be like an instant death. So you had to figure out ways around the maze while avoiding those dots and the ghosts. Other ones would just be like different things with like speed challenges for the day, or maybe the ghosts move really, really fast. But, yeah, I just thought it'd be really fun to have like a daily challenge level. Not as hard as the CAX 2019 challenge level. That was that's a little bit much, but all right, let's see if this works. So we've got this right now. Shit, what did I make it? C? What's his current speed going at right now? That's blinky goal. We don't want that. His current speed is 4.25. Elroy 2 speed is 4.25. Did I mess something up here? Yeah, it was, So we're definitely seeing him change speeds, which is good. Elroy 1 speed is 4. His current speed is 3.75. And if we hit C, his current speed here should change to 4. So he did speed up. Hit it again. 4.25. For some reason, it's not going back. Which is weird. But that could be because our thingy isn't changing. Game settings. Elroy mode. Yeah, it keeps going up. Why is it doing that? Oh, because I did total dots. I did it again, man. There we go. Did Blinky go back to default speed? Current speed 3.75. Yep. 4.25, 3.75. Yeah. Okay, so Cruise Elroy is officially working. We are gonna make a new global value. I'm sure that some of these things in here... Thank you, Molly. I'm sure that some of these things in here I can... get rid of. There's so many global values, and I don't even know if some of these I'm going to be using anymore. Well, let's just make another one. Who cares? This one's going to be call it Elroy option. So we'll make it when it's 0. Zero should be default. So zero will be only modern shows up. We're gonna go down here and we're gonna say something like, yeah, Junior Pac-Man only has one Elroy speed. So we're gonna go insert a new event that's gonna say, compared to a global value, scroll all the way the fuck down in here. Elroy option is lower than or equal to 1 plus add a new condition. We're gonna say direction equals one of the main four directions. And we have to say add a new condition plus animation, which animation of Blinky is playing, stopped. No, maybe walking. We are going to go direction, select direction to be our current direction value plus two. Let's see. So if that equals that, trying to think here, because I think zero is going to be default. One is going to be Cruz Elroy for all skins, whereas default is going to be only modern, and then two will be completely off. So we'll do that. You know what? I got to make two events anyway, so let's just make this equals zero. And then let's copy this, make a new one. Elroy option equals one. And we're going to say set direction to direction plus two. And then we're going to go on this one here, change direction to be current direction value. Oh, I don't like that. Hang on. What did I do? Hello, Sam. How's it going? You actually learned something about it thanks to 37. Are you talking about the Cruz Elroy game that you've been that you played that you made a whole bunch of mazes in? All right, let's see if this works. I don't know if this is gonna work. First of all, let's go turn the ghost style back to normal. So we got our, you know what? Let's get rid of these thingies too because they're in the way. Let's make it so these are not visible at the start. And we're gonna go up here. Make it so these are not visible at start. Okay, we just got our normal ghost. Can actually probably get rid of that thingy too for the time being. I don't need this thing visible either right now. You know what? Same thing for these. These still have the flags on. It does have down blocked on. We're gonna turn that off. Okay. There we go. So we hit C. He speeds up. You know what? We didn't tell it. We didn't tell it what to do here. We're gonna say compare one of the alterable values. Elroy mode is greater than zero. Good. Goes good. How about yourself? It goes pretty well. We've been making a lot of progress tonight, and we've only had minor issues, very minor issues. One minor issue where Ghost went through the wall. But now we may have an issue with him not doing his animation. So in Cruz Elroy mode, Blinky abandons his scatter corner in scatter mode. If you die, Blinky actually temporarily leaves Cruz Elroy mode, which is why he goes back to his corner if you die. He resumes Cruz once all the ghosts... Yeah. If all ghosts are out and Clyde is in, he will not go into Elroy. No, that's totally cool, Molly. I get it. What's happening here? So... we have Elroy option set to zero. Okay, so zero is just the main skin. Do I turn that off up here? Is that what's going on? I do. Okay, we gotta move these. That's what's happening. Where do we move these to? I think I'm just gonna put them in ghost movement as much as I don't want to, but nothing else is really changing. Yeah, it is. There's other things that are changing the direction. It's got to be, man, where do you put this? I guess I just put them here for right now. Yeah, there we go. Now he changes his eyes. Why did that happen? Tired. The third secret Elroy state where he just disappears, right? All right, so let's go back to, I will figure that out later. Let's turn this on and let's see if this actually works. Okay, so we got our default one. Yeah, there we go. Now we got Elroy mode. He gets angry. Let's make sure it works or it doesn't affect other things. Yeah, he seems fine. Oh my gosh. All right, well, there's one other thing we gotta do. And that is with the speed, which is up here. It's because of this stuff here. Plus add a new condition. We need to add a new condition that says flags is a flag off. In ghost house is off. We can't change the speed when he's in the ghost house. Okay, let's go back to Cruz Elroy, turn him on. Do eyes. There we go. There we go. So that works. Let's change the skin. We don't have an Angi skin for this. I mean, we could. We could do... Yeah, we don't have an Angi skin for this. Why doesn't this one do Angi? I thought we did that. This one does Angi. There's the SNES one. It looks good. He does Angi. And the NES one doesn't work. Hang on, what's going on with the NES one? Did I fuck it up? I didn't copy the Angi ones. Oh no, okay, it's fine. It's fine. Yeah, we messed up, but it's fine. It's fine, it's an easy fix. We're just gonna have to go and do the animations again, which again, not hard. I knew we were gonna mess up somewhere tonight on copying all that stuff over, and it's fine. It's absolutely fine. It happens. You know what? For the most part, we made everything else work really, really well. Okay. So now we should be able to do NES Ghost. And we got Engi mode. And you'll notice that I actually made him, I made him flash fast when it's, like, let's advance the levels a little bit. So you can see here how he actually flashes fast there. And like this one here does the normal one. And then we go, let's see here. But this one here does the fast flash. What if we made it so all ghosts could be Elroy mode? What if all ghosts can be on Elroy mode? I mean, I'm gonna probably put the animations in there for all ghosts to be that way. I think it'd be a fun thing. I don't know how I can work it in. But I think it'd be a neat option to have. Well, I think we made a lot of progress. We got all the animations done, and we tightened up the animations that we have. We made the no pass zone, so we got those implemented. That's all taken care of. We made it so that side tunnels can affect which direction ghosts go. And we put in Cruise Elroy mode. So we got a lot of stuff done tonight. That felt good. I think I'm on the verge of pretty much everything with the ghosts being done. I'm trying to think of anything else that needs to be done with them other than exiting the maze and coming out the other side. So that may be the next thing I work on. And then outside of that, I think we're basically done with ghost movement, and I will have to start putting in new ghosts to start testing everything out. But very productive evening. I'm not sure if I'm gonna stream tomorrow or not. Like, I want to. Let's see how I'm feeling. I have tomorrow off. I'm going to be playing some Genshin because I really need to get caught up on stuff in Genshin. Gareth and I were talking about that earlier, and it's just like I haven't had a chance to play Genshin. I haven't had a chance to play Fortnite. I haven't had a chance to really sit down and play games in a while because I've been so focused on this, which is good. I'm loving this, but I definitely keep working on this and not playing games. So, I might just take tomorrow and just chill and enjoy my day. But if I'm feeling like a stream, I'll let you guys know. I don't know what we're gonna do, so we'll see. For right now, I'm trying to find someone I can send you guys over to. Somebody that's streaming something, somebody that may be playing something that we may have an interest in. Everybody's playing. What's he doing? Hang on. You doing 3D stuff? 3D stuff? Do we want to watch 3D stuff? Sure. I don't know how interesting it is, but I'm going to send you guys over to... I don't really know how to pronounce his name. He's working in Godot. And I think his name is... Jitspo? Or it's Jay Itzpo. I don't know. I've got him on my follow list and I watch him because he does some game dev stuff here and there. But I've never really interacted too much. So we're just gonna go raid them. They're doing game dev and stuff that anyway. Quincy, nice first boost. Thank you for the stream. Aw, thank you. Thank you everybody for joining me. I appreciate it. I hope you guys had a wonderful evening. If I don't catch you tomorrow, I will catch you on Thursday. When I get home from work. So, hopefully, I don't know what I was just going to say there. Hopefully, you all have a wonderful evening, and I will catch you next time. Bye-bye!